Rarely runs a bad race. He won at Epsom in June, and last time out finished a highly respectable six in the Royal Hunt Cup, despite being badly drawn. Now, when you consider he humped 10 stone 2 in the Royal Hunt Cup and finished six, that was by no means a bad performance. Certain to be there at the finish, Schmarik, number 5. Going round with Sarab. Two we haven't seen, our great desire. This one, number 3, Benji Coogan rides this for Mel Britton, the owner, private trainer Mel at York, and great desire in brilliant form in the spring, winning 3 races, and it is a much improved performer this year, but he hasn't cut much ice in his last couple of races, and he has had a busy season, but he's a good, tough, genuine sort. Great desire, number 3. And the only one we haven't seen is number 1, Capricorn Bell, in the blue with the white chevron, just coming into the picture any second now. There he is, and Sarab is odds on, 11 to 10 on the field now. Sarab 11 to 10 on favorite. This is Capricorn Bell in the background there. Ray Guest rides this for Luca Cumani, who has a 71% strike rate here at Newcastle. She won her last 4 races last season and won the Van Geest at Newmarket last month. Tends to take her stronghold, but they've been holding her up this year for a late challenge, and she'll go well, no doubt about that. Capricorn Bell, number 1, and more news on the betting, John.
And Capricorn Bell is 4-1, opened up at 3-1. The money is for Try to Stop Me now, a 12-1 chance in 20s. Sarab, the 11-10 on favourite. Capricorn Bell at 4. Schmarik, 9-2. Redizer, 9-1. Red Rock Steady at 12-1. Try to Stop Me also at 12s. And Mavra still the 25-1 outsider of 7. They all show.
Well, London property developer Wilkie Wilkinson owns Try to Stop Me. Must have told one or two of his mates. They must have had a couple of pounds on, but obviously good money for Try to Stop Me. Beswing, incidentally, the name of the race, he won the Northumberland Plate in 1838 and won the Newcastle Gold Cup 6 years running. That race was over 4 miles, would you believe? But this race over the straight 7 furlongs, it looks as if Schmarik is going to be the last. Sarab, more money for him. Solid favourite, 5-4 on favourite at the off. Over to Graham.
And the 7 runners have won 35 races and nearly £250,000 in prize money. And there's not that much pace early on. Mavara has made the running in the past and is disputing it with Try to Stop Me. And if there isn't that much pace, that could suit the favourite Sarab, who certainly has a turn of foot. Schmarik is the back marker. Capricorn Bell relaxed in her race. Her best runs come in a fast run race, which at the moment this doesn't seem to be. As Try to Stop Me and Mavara dispute the early running from Grey Desire. Then comes Red Rocks and Schmarik and Sarab and Capricorn Bell. They're all coming on the stand side, and this could develop into a sprint, which should suit Sarab, the favourite in the dark green jacket, 3 from the left, just shaded by the grey horse, Grey Desire, who tracks the leader, Try to Stop Me, who just has the call over Mavara on the outside. So they're just beginning to stretch now. Tony I is asking Try to Stop Me to quicken, and he's finding a bit. They've got 3.5 furlongs to race at the halfway stage in the Beswing Stakes, and Try to Stop Me with Mavara. Then comes Grey Desire, Red Rocks running backwards, Capricorn Bell coming with a run, Sarab in the dark green jacket getting ever closer, but so too is Schmarik. It's a very open race for 1.5 furlongs to go, and it's Try to Stop Me from Sarab now up on the outside, and Sarab goes for home with a furlong to race. Sarab quickening up from Schmarik in second place. Capricorn Bell switched to the outside, finishing fast, but it'll only take second place at best close home, because it's Sarab who's clear as he comes up towards the line. Sarab is the easy winner. Capricorn Bell and Schmarik in a photo for 2, 3, 4 race. Mavara 5, came home Grey Desire, then Try to Stop Me and Red Rocks. I think you can ignore his run here, although he has run a little bit disappointingly for the second consecutive.